Marks and Spencers.
Which, if you don't know, is a very bougie, probably the bougiest supermarket in the UK. Really, really nice food, but also very pricey. Yep. Start off with a tiny bit of a cheat, which is the Halloween munch.
It's got like a whole like mix of different things in there.
I'm personally not eating that.
I'm jelly bean in here.
Are we wanting to rate these products, aren't I?
We could do that, I thought about that. I got good jelly bean on there. Sorry.
For me.
Made in Germany. They're just shaped. That's it.
That texture, though. We only have three things after this.
Three. Well, we can come back and eat our favourite ones.
Yeah.
Solid then.
Really?
I'm eating them.
Really good. Where's my drink?
Drink break.
So Oasis.
Did I say nine? You said 9.5. Change to a 10. I feel like I'm so like I don't know, eye rolling often about like, oh yeah, but it has to be perfect. That is as close to perfect as I would expect
from a cheese puff.
Yeah. I think it's good to maybe like, are they my favourite crisps I've ever eaten in my life?
I don't understand that point of like, when we always say, is it compared to the actual thing it is, or is it like out of anything? That's really hard to think about.
But even within that context, it's hard to say for that.
Yeah, but what about if like the most beautifully cooked steak and chips?
Okay, next up, very excitingly.
And Pop Halloween mini bites.
The ouch wasn't actually part of the name.
No. Yes, we got it good. Okay, and it says, with popping candy.
Oh god.
ASMR. Orange flavoured clusters of cornflake love pretzels.
There's cornflake love in there.
Cornflake. Someone keeps it together. Cornflake. Corn cake. Sorry, fruity nuggets and petrifying popping candy covered in milk chocolate. I have the feeling these are going to be sensational. is the fruit jellies. I don't really like fruit jelly, like jelly beans, or like any sweets mixed with chocolate, really. And number two, I would personally much prefer these if they were not orange.
I like the fact they're orange. I don't like many other flavours with my chocolate.
I would just prefer it to be a beautiful milk chocolate.
Flavouring in there. I like the fruity flavouring, so I get why you don't. But
it was a really nice balance, like it was good orange chocolate. I just prefer it with that.
My original, it's interesting to say that because my reasoning for putting this higher is because I think it's better because it's flavoured. You think it's worse because it is.
I don't necessarily think it's worse, I just personally preferred it.
That's like, but yeah, okay.
If it was normal milk chocolate. Should we do one more sweet? Should we do one more sweet or the second savoury?
One more sweet. I don't know. Savoury. You seem to judge me when I say this. I like these ones.
Of course you will. These are the trick or treat ghostly chili cheese tortillas.
Yeah, but I mean because it's not got a dip. I like my chips with a dip.
Thank you. actually tastes fresh, to be honest.
Yeah.
And I do really like the seasoning.
Very good. Remember we were at the shop and I get an egg.
I've loved it.
But we did watch the movie with avocado.
Yeah, that's not a word for women, is it?
I wrote it as M&S as I deliver it. Is it not the same company?
It's like some of the stuff is, yeah, but, oh no, I think it might be Waitrose. No.
It's definitely M&S, 90%. Got me down in it now. So.
Right. That is going to be for me. A 9 out of 10.
It's an 8. I prefer the other ones. Yeah, the like sort of savoury, sort of crispy thing. Like, what would I eat? Prefer to eat more of probably them, but at the same time, they are more universal.
And I just like, also I'm just thinking, I could make them better. So for me, there's nothing that could make them better.
Yeah, I don't know. I kind of get it. I don't know. I feel in my bones giving it either an 8 just isn't right for me. I don't know why I couldn't articulate that.
I understand
personally. I feel like maybe because in my mind I go, there could be better chips out there. Whereas I just did not feel it for
some
of the others. Like, I'd just be like, they are the best. I'll ever eat.
That can go now. Okay, two more items left. And even though I want to save this one to last, I think we should do the most iconic one last.
Yeah, I agree.
So this is probably,
now you know what it is. Actually, it might be hidden by the number time.
This is probably going to be. I think this is going to be my favourite sweet treat, and this is the spooky cookie dough. I don't know why the cookie is spelled with a K, but there we go. So this says salted fudgy cookie dough.
I don't like cookie dough, so I'm actually thinking this might be my least favourite.
I love it with candy and brownie pieces enrobed in white and milk chocolate. That's my favourite. It just sounds for me so good.
Can I open curly?
That was unsatisfying, wasn't it? See it, so.
That is unfortunate. Not sure I'm enjoying that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's happening. I need a cultural reset after that. I just don't understand how you like that, to be honest. It just tastes...
I have no idea how you don't.
Pleasant.
What about him?
I didn't like... I don't know, I don't mess with fudge, honestly, personally. But also...
But I don't even know if that is fudge. It's just a fudgy cookie.
Yeah, but it's got, like, it's the texture of fudge. It's that sort of, like... It's thick.
But you like fudgy chocolate brownies.
Do I, though?
I think so. You like a gooey brownie.
I like a gooey brownie, but gooey brownie's not fudge.
You also like...
That's not what that is, though.
You also... also like underbaked cookies.
Underbaked? Yeah, but it's different. It doesn't come along with the same taste. And if undercooked cookies taste rancid, then I won't eat them. I just don't. Everything about that just was unpleasant to me.
That's crazy. I just don't get it. You get these on the big ones as well, and that bit is really thick.
You just gotta make sure that you eat it. Sort of, like, gotta be careful how you eat it. Because if you eat it down this way, saliva might drip down and you'll get a bit of sloppy head at the end.
That's just disgusting.
Oh, my God. can't stop yet. Certainly not from Colin.
You're gross.
Thoughts?
Very nice.
Is that it?
7.5 out of 10.
6. But, like, I just don't. That to me, I just feel a little bit like I want a drink.
Yeah, you need a
bit of milk. Back to them. Crisps.
I was just going to say, now for the part where you said about going back to our favourite items. That's going to be the... If you are from the UK or find yourself in the UK, you need to grab yourself some vampire fangs. Press the bomb.
I hope you enjoyed the video today.
Oh yeah.
I certainly did. That was a lot of fun, that one.
I really enjoyed it.
That was nice. I think that was a better way of doing it, going one by one to each of those things and just eating rather than getting them all out at once.
Have we ever done that before?
Yeah, I think we did that with the... I think we showed off and opened all of the Christmas ones last year. But I think this works so much better. Isn't this nice and cosy, guys?
It's so cosy.
Let's have a little real fireplace. Maybe we can build one.
If you got this far in the video, please can you leave a caterpillar emoji?
And if there isn't one of those,
I think there is.
Drop the skull.
Sure. Yeah, oh yeah, actually, I guess depending on the phone.
Yeah.
So if you don't have a caterpillar emoji, drop a skull in the comments down below.
Does anyone remember that?
If you like the video, make sure you smash that thumbs up button and
subscribe.
If you haven't already, hit that bing bong bing bong bing bong bell button to be alerted every single time VG ASMR uploads a video, and maybe you'll see me on the thumbnail ever so often.
And maybe not.
And probably not, but quick, click those flipping videos, please. Click them.